Assalamu alaikum. Oftentimes we're asked, how can I give da'wah to a Latino? And honestly, da'wah to Latinos in the best form is given or delivered in their language. Da'wah to a Latino in the Spanish language is touching their mother tongue, literally that the mother spoke to them or their grandmother spoke to them, which is the language that they're most filled with confidence to hear. And the issue of Latinos giving da'wah to other Latinos, even if we may speak English, living in America, there's something about the Spanish language that when we hear it, there's a different tone to it. Many times the Muslims who are not Latino, trying to give da'wah to a Latino, they may come to us and ask, how do I do this? Obviously, someone from another ethnicity may not necessarily speak the language. And it's not only the language that has to be considered here, it's the transmission of their cultural values and the way that they perceive life. This is why Allah sent every single messenger to speak in the language of their people. As Allah said in the Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِن رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَا لَهُمْ وَيُدِلُّ اللَّهُ مَن يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي مَن يَشَاءُ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Allah said, I didn't send the messenger except that he spoke the language of their people in order to clarify the message for them. Then after that's clarified, Allah guides whomsoever He wills and leaves astray whomsoever He wills. And He is the Almighty, the All-Wise. If Allah chose people from amongst their people to be able to convey the message of Islam, as a community with the Muslim community, we have to know that if a person is not Latino, they want to reach a Latino, it's good that they team up with a Latino and see if they can, you know, work together in being able to inform this individual who happens to be Latino, because it's someone close to their nature, someone closer to their background. This usually breaks a lot of the different cultural gaps that may exist. In case of a person from an Arab country or Indo-Pakistan or Indonesia being able to say, hey, as a Latino, let me tell you about Islam. Sometimes they may see that they're coming from a cultural sense. But if we as Latinos start speaking to them and say, hola, ¿cómo estás? ¿De dónde eres? All of a sudden it breaks that cultural background. Just by asking, hey, where are you from? You know, people can relate and they see, wow, you're Muslim? And then that's how the whole conversation happens. We've seen a lot of success in being able to deal with the people in the language. For those that want to know a few key words in the Spanish language, like Allah es uno, Allah is one. If you were to say this little statement to a regular Spanish speaker, they would be hit. Like, what is this Allah, and tell me more about it? So speaking to the people in their language as Latinos is the best way to reach them. And this is why large organizations sometimes, when trying to, you know, attract Latinos or tell them about Islam, if they don't find somebody from their old cultural background, it's going to be a challenge. And even when they find someone from their cultural background, if they don't understand the strategy as to how to communicate with them, we often see that there's challenges. We have used this language as a gift to be able to share the message of Islam with the people. And we also work together with general Muslims that want to understand these small little phrases that may really make a change in someone's perception about Islam and even themselves or their perception as Muslims. So Allah is uno may be the one transmission of the message that you may be able to deliver to a Latino.
Thank you very much for tuning in. We hope you benefited from these videos. Don't forget to leave your comments and questions below. And for more videos like this, please subscribe. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.